Blackstone Publishing presents Saying No is Not Enough, Second Edition, Helping Your Kids Make Wise Decisions About Alcohol, Tobacco, and Other Drugs, A Guide for Parents of Children Ages 3 through 19, by Robert Schwebel, Ph.D. This book is read by Mike Chamberlain. Introduction to the audio version of Saying No is Not Enough. I'm pleased that Saying No is Not Enough has passed the test of time, is still being read and used by families, and is now being released as an audiobook. Although drugs of choice and drug laws change over time, new drugs emerge, and the street names vary, as they are prone to do, the basic principles for preventing drug problems have remained the same. When I wrote the first edition of this book, and to this day, I stand by my conviction that the key component to drug prevention is very simple. Create healthy environments and help young people learn to make wise decisions. To the extent we raise children who can satisfy their needs, get along well with others, and experience satisfaction and success in life, we reduce the likelihood of drug problems. Happy and competent young people are less likely to develop serious drug issues. They can make their own wise and informed decisions. The first half of this book provides ideas about how to support children in their personal growth. In this book, I introduced the idea of describing the trajectory of childhood as a transfer of power. At birth, babies are entirely dependent on their parents, who make all the decisions. Usually by age 18 or so, young people will likely leave the nest, gain independence, and should be equipped to run their own lives. During this entire time span, forward-thinking parents empower their children with incremental increases of freedom and responsibility so that they are prepared for adulthood. Infants and young children need clear direction and guidance. They need to be protected by adults from hazards and should be in safe environments in which they begin both to learn about drugs and to gain mastery over the world. This includes learning various life and social skills that will enable them to satisfy their needs without having to rely on drugs. Adolescence is more complex. Science and real-life experience tell us that adolescents don't take kindly to adults who try to control their behavior without giving them a voice. It's a sensitive period of development that marks the transition from childhood to adulthood. In this book, I introduce the controversial idea of young people making their own decisions about drugs. It was not an easy sell years ago, and is not an easy sell even now, especially with the rise in opioid use. Parents and other adults tend to fall back to a reliance on rules and punishment. They are understandably frightened about the dangers of drugs and find it difficult to let go of control and to allow young people to think through decisions for themselves. Yet this is exactly what needs to happen if we want to prevent drug problems. I want to reiterate my premise that saying no is not enough. We need to wake up and abandon the myth of drug-free youth, accept the reality that young people have access to alcohol and other drugs, and that many of them will try drugs, and some will begin to use them. Let's prepare young people for the real world. Adolescents face the developmental challenges of forming their own individual identities and of beginning to master formal operational thinking, which means the ability to consider all the options available to them and the impact of each. They need learning experiences that will prepare them for adult roles. Because drugs are so prevalent in our culture, they need an opportunity to define their own identity in relationship to drugs. That includes a safe, free-thinking zone where they can make their own informed decisions, backed up by the support of adults who care about them and won't try to dictate their behavior. Soon they will be young adults, and it is unfair to send them unprepared into independent life.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.